Hey, what's up YouTube? Hey guys, we're back. We're gonna be doing another project today on the 1978 Lincoln Continental Town Car. The ignition as of late has been leaking a fluid. Check up here, look at these pictures that I'm attaching here. It's literally just sleeping, it's like slime just coming out of it. So anyways, it's not good. What I found out is that this right here, once the ignition module starts going bad on it, it starts melting from the heat, and the goop is what you see that's running down the fender. So, naturally, since I had this one, I went ahead and I painted it and put a nice little Lincoln sticker on it just to kind of dress it up just a little bit. And I'm going to show you guys how to remove the plugs, how you get to these screws on the bottom here, and just basically how the whole thing is done. So, anyways, thanks for joining. Please hit that like, subscribe, and share, and thanks. Bye. So I'm going to try to get you guys in a little bit closer to get a look at this. So this right here is the ignition module. This is the original one. It's 42 years old as of November. This car was manufactured in November of 78. So this is its birth month, so to speak. But if you follow along the back here, okay, you see that? It looks almost like a like something that would come out of a glue gun, right? Well, there's a compound that's inside of the ignition module that insulates all the electronics in it, and when it starts going bad, it gets hot. Once it gets to a certain temperature, it liquefies. And you can see it kind of just runs down the fender here. So these are the plugs right here. I'm gonna take a pick and I'm going to get these off. These are the originals, so I don't wanna break them. So I'm just, please root for me because, they're old, they're brittle, they're gonna be tight. So I just wanna get them off without actually damaging them. So anyways, stay tuned. I'll figure out a place to put this camera and see if I can show you guys exactly what it takes to actually get it unplugged. Also, I want you to make sure that you've taken the positive of the battery cable off, so the electrical system is discharged when you do this. Also, we're gonna chop our wheels, okay? Turn the wheel all the way to the right, as you saw in the picture. Okay, try and get you a good shot on this. Okay, you see those three bolts right there? That is what is holding the ignition module on. We are gonna take these off. I have found these to be, let's take a look. Okay, so I got a 3/8 drive ratchet, 3/8 drive extension short, and then we've got a 7/16. That's what's gonna take to bust those bolts loose. So, and they should come out just fine. I haven't had any problems with any of the screws on this vehicle, so I can tell the vehicle is always kept in the garage. Because even though sometimes the bolts have like a little bit of surface rust on them, come right out. Now, the other thing too, your ignition in your vehicle, whether it's a Ford, Lincoln, Mercury, whatever, the Duraspark is in a lot of vehicles from the early 70s to the late 80s. And that's a fact, right? Well, you see how this has a blue tab? That's what you match yours up to. I'm gonna put a picture up here in just a moment, and it's gonna explain to you what all the different tabs are. Okay, so anyway, stick around and we're gonna get it done. Bye. GoPro, stop. Okay, so this is that pick I was telling you about. I'm gonna try to get you guys in here. Trying not to move my head too much. Oh, hear that? Oh man, it's already breaking. Jeez, it's so brittle. There's really nothing I can do, guys. You hear it, man? Yeah, look at that, broke. Well, at least what I'm finding is that is on the side Oh, come on. Looks like, that's on the module side. So that'll in essence be getting replaced, but golly. Yeah, nice. Okay, so I'm gonna take some electrical cleaner. We're gonna hit that. Okay, let's get this other one too while we're at it. Okay, so it doesn't matter if these break because that's on the old one. What we don't wanna break is the side of, yes. Okay, there we go. All right, so we got that. That's the first thing. Come check out the electrical cleaner. Okay, let's see here. Okay, so this is it right here. Okay, hope y'all got a good shot of that. If not, I'm sorry. I'll also attach a picture just in case. We're gonna get the little, I wish I knew where the little spray nozzle was, so I'm gonna see if I can borrow one from another one. Yes. Here. Oh, no. Yes, and we're gonna need this as well. Okay, dielectric grease. So we set it right this time. Okay, set that there. We need eye protection, okay? Don't take no chances. I'm telling you, especially if you made it this far in life. Serious, don't play. Emergency brakes, wheels chalk, okay? That way if you make a mistake, you've got your own back. You understand what I'm saying? Let's make this fun. Yes, we'll put some of that in there. Put that in there. Alright, now what we need is, where are you? Cleaning that up. Okay. Very nice. Okay, we're gonna hit it one more time. Let's see if we can get some little bit more out of this. Yep. Okay. Hit the other one. Okay. Very good. Let's get this out. Make sure we don't get none in the paint. Okay. In fact, while we're thinking about that, let's go ahead. That dry for a little bit. Okay, let's take the grease. Okay. Well, looks like I'm almost out of this. So we'll manually apply it, like so. This is much better than that stuff from the 70s. So we don't need near as much. But we will put enough on there to make sure that it gives it like a waterproof seal around the contact surface. So I'm liking that. We've got enough there. Should get some on the very end. At least we have enough. Okay. Okay, so now we got that done. Okay, so now let's get our ratchet. Oh, you know what else we want to do? Let's go and wipe our hands one time, because look at that. In case we inadvertently touch something we don't want to. And I've got some paper towels over here. Okay, let's see here. Let's see. I'm not sure if y'all be able to see this or not. But here we go, cover me, I'm going in. Haha. Well, at least the thing's gonna go off. But I will need to find another screw like that. But we will be fine. That's not gonna stop us. But you saw that, right? The head broke off. I'm gonna tell them what the underbelly of that ignition module looks like. That one, see, it broke clean off. At least it broke. That way the ignition module comes out. Two screws will hold it in place so I can come across another bolt like it. Okay, so I wanna, oh, yeah, look at that. Well, okay, there it is. Well, I'm gonna clean this up. Not sure. Somebody said peel it off. It doesn't look like it. I need to find. I got some stuff that maybe might break it down. We'll see. That's it's everywhere. All right, moving on. All right, here we go. So that is the old one. You can see something right here around that area is really causing a lot of heat. Anyways, I'm gonna use it as a backup still because it works still. So in an emergency situation, if this one burns out, I can put that one back in and maybe possibly get to a gas station or a hotel and deal with it the next morning, you know what I mean? So, all right, so my hands are clean. I don't want to get any stuff on it, mess up the paint, and we'll see how this goes out. But basically what we're gonna do is we are going to set this like so. Oh, grab a nut, find one of the holes and pray, because I cannot see it. Okay. Oh, okay, see? Oh man, I hope they are getting this. Okay. It's kind of tight. If I like that. Okay. Let's go for another one. I'm trying to get the one at the very, very end. This one's all by feel. Sounds like I might have it. I don't know. Yeah, it feels like it. But God, like the bolt sure does feel like it's really tight, man. That kind of stresses me out. Okay. Okay, I'm having to do this blind. Okay, let's not do it blind. Okay. Well, I'll tell you what. Doesn't feel that bad. Okay, here we go. That's good for that one. Don't want to over tighten it. Go down to the other one again. Having to do this blind. Oh, please. Okay, that one seems to be turning okay. Okay. Very good. Okay. Like I said, we're gonna have to look for a replacement screw for this, but for as of right, oh, look, I must have made a mistake. That one's not all the way in. Okay. Ooh. Yeah, break. Almost. Okay. Yeah, still feels like you can go just a little bit more, huh? Gosh. It's tight. We're going with that. I don't want to take a chance of that bolt breaking off as well. Okay, so we've already applied our grease. So you guys saw before, you just take the pick. You can break the other ones because the new ignition system is going to bring new locking tabs along with it. Okay, both of them are connected. So that's the one that's missing right there. So we'll have to do something about that. I'm not gonna leave it like that. But, okay, well, let's move any. Make sure we don't. Okay. All right, here we go. Will it work? I like the Lincoln sign. It's kind of neat. Got the keys. Choke is already set. Nervous. There you have it, guys. Let's pray to God that it doesn't start smoking. Not the engine, but the electronics, and that's a joke. I pray it's gonna work good for sure. See how smooth it runs. I'm gonna go ahead and paint this today. I've got a new sticker that's gonna go here. Already painted this, but got the reproduction sticker there. A little bit at a time. Well, anyway, thanks for checking it out. Make sure you guys like and subscribe. Thanks. Bye.